This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create classical marble busts from photos. The photos can be black and white continuous tone or color. I provided these images for you to download so you can follow along. Their links are located in the video description or project files. I'll use this one for this video. Open a photo of someone who's facing you and is lit from the front. It's important that the lighting be even throughout the face. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock.com. To get your photo into the sculpture document, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of the sculpture document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the image and then release. Before we resize it, reduce its opacity to approximately 40% so we can see through it. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl-T on Windows or Command-T on a Mac. If you can't see the Transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command-0. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt-Shift on Windows or Option-Shift on a Mac as you drag it in or out until the size of your subject's head is approximately the same size as the head on the sculpture. If you want to tilt the photo, go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate the transform. Continue to size and position it until the eyes, nose, and mouth are in correct proportions to the sculpture's face. Then press Enter or Return. Now we can bring the opacity back to 100%. Make a copy of your photo by pressing Ctrl or Command-J. Remove all its color by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-U. Click off the eyeball next to the color photo to hide the layer. Now, the only visible layers are the black and white photo and the sculpture. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer, and then invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command-I. Think of a layer mask as a stencil. Whatever is black in the layer mask will hide the photo, and whatever is white will reveal areas of the photo. We need to make the foreground color white. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Invert them by pressing X or click this icon. Now, white is the foreground color. Open your brush tool. Make the size approximately 40 pixels, make the hardness 0%, and increase the opacity to 100%. Press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open your brush panel. Make sure the only setting that's checked is smoothing. Press F5 again to close the panel. Press Z to open your Zoom tool and drag a rectangle over the head. Press B to open your brush tool and brush over the face to reveal your subject. Remember, since the layer mask is active, you're actually brushing white over the layer mask, which in turn is revealing areas of the black and white photo. To mask out areas of your subject, we need to brush black over the layer mask. To do this, invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Now, brush over areas you want to mask out. To make your brush larger or smaller, press the right or left bracket keys. To reposition the image on your screen, press and hold the space bar as you drag the image. Continue to carefully brush white or black over areas to reveal or mask the face on the sculpture base. Next, we'll remove the irises from the eyes. Click the photo to make it active, open your Zoom tool, and zoom into the eyes. Open your Eyedropper tool. Click outside the iris to pick up the color, make your brush smaller, and carefully brush over the inside of the eyes. Open your Blur tool, make its strength 100%, and brush over the eyelids to soften them a little. Open your smudge tool, make its strength 100%, and smudge areas of similar tones to blend them into each other. Smudging your image gives it a smooth, almost plastic look. To zoom out, press Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard a few times. Make sure your brush strokes follow the same directions as the wrinkles and contours of the features. It's also important not to brush over distinct areas of contrast, like the nostrils and between the lips. To smudge smaller areas, reduce the size of your smudge tool. Continue to finesse the face until it's smooth and there's no skin pores. I'd like to brighten the areas where the irises were, so I'll open my Dodge tool, click this icon to revert the colors to black and white, and then click this icon to invert them. Make your brush size fit the area you'd like to brighten. Reduce the exposure to approximately 20% and choose the range that approximates the tonal values of the areas you want to brighten. I'll choose mid-tones because the area isn't too dark nor light. Now, gently brush over the middle of the eyes. If you want to blend them in more, use your smudge tool. Remember, if areas of the face are too dark or too light, use your Dodge or Burn tools to brighten or darken them. Make sure you're using white for the Dodge tool and black for the Burn tool, and that you're choosing the appropriate range for the tones you're brightening or darkening. Also, reduce the exposure way down. Press Ctrl or Command 0 to fit the document back onto your screen. Next, we'll add a reflective sheen to the marble. First, make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Click the Channels tab. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. I included an alpha channel of the sculpture's silhouette. Ctrl-click or Command-click on its thumbnail to make a selection of its shape. Click back on the Layers panel and press Ctrl or Command-J to cut the sculpture from its background and copy it to its own layer. Make a new layer below the active layer by Ctrl-clicking or Command-clicking on the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with black. If your background color is black, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Click the thumbnail of the cutout sculpture to make it active, and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Artistic folder and click Plastic Wrap. I'm using these settings, but feel free to play with them to get just the right amount of detail and sheen that you like on your marble. Then click OK. If you want to make the neck a bit thinner, make another composite snapshot, make black your foreground color, and zoom into the neck. Open your brush tool, reduce its size, and brush over the outside areas of the neck. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.